Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for being here. Over the past 24 hours, the president has continued to improve. He's met or exceeded all standard hospital discharge criteria. He'll receive another dose of remdesivir here today, and then we plan to get him home. It's been more than 72 hours since his last fever. Oxygen levels, including ambulatory saturations and his work of breathing, are all normal. Though he may not entirely be out of the woods yet, the team and I agree that all our evaluations, and most importantly, his clinical status, support the president's safe return home, where he'll be surrounded by world-class medical care 24/7.
Yesterday evening, the president received his third dose of remdesivir. He tolerated that infusion without difficulty, and his kidney and liver function continued to be normal. Our plan is to give the fourth dose of remdesivir this evening before he goes back to the White House, and we've made arrangements to deliver the fifth and final dose of his treatment course at the White House tomorrow evening. He continues on dexamethasone, and again, the plan for today is to continue to be up and out of bed, eat and drink, and work as he is able.
What infection control measures are you taking? And how was it safe for him to drive around in a cloth mask yesterday? And how is it safe for him now to return to the White House where there have been so many cases? How's any of this safe?
So the president has been surrounded by medical and security staff for days, wearing full PPE. And yesterday, the U.S. Secret Service agents were in that same level of PPE for a very short period of time. We've worked with our infectious disease experts to make some recommendations for how to keep everything safe down at the White House for the president and those around him. We're looking at where he's going to be able to carry out his duties, office space, and I'll just say that it's in line with everything we've been doing upstairs for the last several days.